Hi everyone, this is Aki with another quick video on keynotes and how to work with images, how to crop them, how to use mask, how to use instant alpha, cutout shape, and so on. So let's get started. So I have some sample images and I just like to make duplicate slides. So in case I mess up, I can start over. So we have this image right now here, and let's say I want to crop it. You just can double click on the image, or you can click, select the image and go to the format option on the right and image. And I'm going to just actually use right here, double click on it. And at the bottom, you have these options. So the first one, it's basically helping you resize the image. So you can zoom the image and resize it. The second one allows you to crop it. So if I want to crop it, I have this error showing up, so I can just drag the size of it to make it smaller and to show what I want. Now, what I like about these edits, it's basically they're not destructive. So my image is still there if I change my mind later on and click done. So that's what we have. But now let's say I want to remove this background and I just want this one flower. For that, you would want to use Instant Alpha. So Instant Alpha is basically removing the background. So you can select the image now and then click on Format Image Instant Alpha. You click that and now you have this kind of a little pointer showing, asking you to select the color you want to remove. So once I click and then drag, it's going to remove these colors and you can see what it's removing. The more you drag, it's going to increase the selection. So once, you know, you can see that it's going to take away the flower, like at this point, you want to go back. So I went back and I'm going to click, I'm going to unclick to select this. Now, then you still have like these other areas, so you can just go to these areas and select individually. So you might have to, you know, play around with this a bit, especially if you have a lot of different colors and selections and sections and so on. And so right now, if I click done, this is my image. Now I can still see this flower on the side. I can still work on this. So I can still select the image, click Instant Alpha, and even though it's the same color, I can just go and drag to this flower, but I have to be careful so it doesn't take away my flower, the main flower that I want. So it might just take a bit of patience and to work on this. And you know, this is a complicated image, and I'll show you how it is with like different icons. So you see, that's what I have right now, and I can still crop it farther if I want to just remove it like that, you know, and you can keep working at that. So let me show you how it is with icons. So I have these, you know, icons and shapes. They're not images, and the way to work on it. So let's say I have something that I transfer with my logo, but I'm like, I just want to have this logo, not the name there. So I can increase this. And again, I can double click, then crop it manually like this. And maybe try to remove the name and just have an icon and click done. Now, if you want to resize it, you want to make sure when you click on the image, if you go to arrange, you have this constraint proportion option selected, because what happens if I don't, if I'm going to try to increase it, you see it's distorting it. It's not being proportional. So I'm going to undo and I'm going to check the constraint proportion and then resize it. So I have this like right there. Now, I want to remove that color. So what I'm going to do is select the image, go to image, Instant Alpha, and select that gray color and click OK. Now you see the image that the true image was, like with my name and so on, it's showing up because you never destroy it. It's not a destructive editing. So you can always go back and change things. So that's really helpful. So, okay, so that's what I have. And okay, so I like this. Now, I know like that this is white color. How? Because I have you know, saved it that way, but you can't tell right now because the background of the slide is white. So I'm going to change the slide color to kind of show you. On the right, if you click format and then color fill, I'm going to change it to maybe like light gray. So now you can tell that my icon actually has this white color. So let's say if I wanted to make it transparent, I would want to select my image one more time, go back to Instant Alpha, and now try to remove the white color. The more you go, the more you will take some of the blackness out. So you want to be careful not to take too much. And wanted to show you like some of the shapes like this one. You see it has a lot of these unique other things in between. So that will be very hard to remove the background versus like this shape right here, which is very straight forward, just straight lines and not too many things going on. So you see, like, so this is how, like, I can see that it's kind of messed up a little bit here, but I have it transparent and how you can tell. Let me show you, like, if you want to, like, if I'm dragging the image right now, it's going under the image. You just have to go to arrange and move it front. So now it can go, move over the image. Now let's try with the yellow one. It might be even harder because the yellow color might be harder to take out from the black edges. So if I do that, select image. And now if I click and drag, you can see, I can still see the yellow and it's taking away more of the black, and click done. You see, it took away more of my icon. So, I mean, I can reduce it, I can undo it and, you know, do it to this point. So, you know, you just have to play around with it and see what works for you. Okay. Now let's try this one. It was very easy. You see, very straightforward. And okay, now let's say I have this and I want to export this, let's say this icon as a transparent icon that I can use somewhere else. So I'm going to add a slide, empty slide, and I'm going to copy over the sun here. And now if I try to export it, let's say I want to resize it, make it large. Now, if I want to export it, let me just also still work a little bit on the Instant Alpha just to make sure that it's taking more of this gray. Okay, so let's say we have this shape, you know, and now we want to export it. Now, if I export it, actually with export with this white background. So what you want to do, you want to save the background of the slide as transparent. So you click on the right, format, background, and then you want to do no fill. So you see what happens? Now the background is black. It's actually not black, it's transparent. But I'm going to export this, go to file, export images. Now you want to select which slide. So this is slide 13. So I'm going to put slide 13. You can select which slide. And then you want to make sure you select PNG, because you see, if I do JPEG doesn't support transparent backgrounds. So you want to use the PNG and click the export with transparent background. And I'm going to, you know, say sample image. And now go to the images. If I double click, you can't tell because it's gray, right? So I'm going to just like actually select Command A, copy. And I'm going to go to this file that I have, empty canvas here, and I'm going to paste. You see, it's transparent because there is no background. The gray background that you see right here, it's not here. So now you can use these images in different ways. Maybe on website or on presentation. Now let's go back to Keynote. One more thing I want to show you. So let's duplicate this. Actually, I have another copy here. And let's say you want to cut out a shape in this image. So I would click on this image and go to format, image, mask with shape. And let's say I want to do an oval. So now you can Make sure you select. Why is it not making a perfect shape? Okay, so I guess Option and Shift you have to hold to make it a perfect shape. Okay, now let's say I want to move it around where I want it. How do I want to zoom? Let's say this, and then click Done. And so this would be the shape. Now let's say you already have a different shape, not the ones that were available at the Format option. So let's make duplication. And now let's say I'm going to use this shape that I actually like, this shape. And the way to find these shapes, any shapes that you like, you can go to Shape at the top menu, and there's plenty of shapes here, objects, animals, so on. And you can save some shapes, create shapes, and save there as well. So I have this shape that I would love to have this flower inside just these black areas of the shape. So the way to do it, if you select both, so you can just do Control A or just like drag it across the two, the image and the shape, and go to Format, Image, Mask with Selection. So before we did Mask with Shape and opted which shape, but now we have Mask with Selection. So now you see it's doing it, and I can still resize it, the image inside, and drag it to position it where I want, and now I have a shape, the flower inside my shape. So hopefully this helps you work with images in Keynote and have some options that are more creative in your presentation or other uses. So thanks for watching.